This is why I woke up for this.
Look at the little sun starting to peek over the horizon. So cool watching it happen.
It actually happens a lot like faster than you would think. Like the second you start seeing it like peek over the horizon, it just fully comes. So cool. Taking Milo for his very last run on the beach this morning. Before we get going here, still have a few things to do, but still pretty early. I don't even think it's quite 7 o'clock yet. Probably not gonna leave this spot until like probably say like around 8, since we're just like right outside of town and I don't think many things open until then anyway. So gonna have a nice easy going morning and then get all the errands we gotta do today. What do you think, Bubs? You ready? Ready to go to the beach? Alright, so we packed it up, decided to leave this place, but we gotta go into town today, do some last errands before we head into the US in the next like 2 days or so. So yeah, we're about to get today started. So we just dropped the laundry off. Like Yaz was saying in another video, it's a whole day event, so we got 4 hours to kill. So we're just walking down the Melicon here. Milo, loving it. Not a bad place to hang out for the next 4 hours. So we made it back to this camp spot. Like I've said before, it's actually the first place that we stayed in Baja. We were here for one night in the last video. Here's the laundry. Got it all done. Needs to be folded. Gonna put the duvet back together. Turn this into a couch. Milo's out there is getting a little cranky because I'm leaving him out there until I'm done in here. And then yeah, it's so hot. I'm sweating like crazy. The van's kind of a mess. So I think tomorrow I'm gonna spend the day and totally clean it out. I got everything I need for that. So yeah, we're gonna turn this back into a couch, get this laundry put away, and we'll check back in. Well, that's better. Milo's loving the blanket. I think we're just gonna hang out in that chair for a little bit, just relax, before taking for a walk on the beach, because I did take him for quite a long walk in town and it's a really hot one. I don't know if you can tell, I'm super sweaty. Yeah, we went for a pretty long walk. We actually got to see some old friends that we made down in La Paz, so that was like super cool getting to meet up back up with them again for a couple hours while we waited. Yeah, I hear you, Milo. You're getting grumpy, aren't you? Yeah, he's getting grumpy, so I'm not giving him any attention. It's okay, I'm coming. All right, well, I better get out there and hang out with him, eh? Just taking Milo for his walk on the beach before we get dinner going here. Look how far the tide goes out. Like I was saying in the other video, I do not remember it like that, but got the nice mountains there. Not a bad spot. And like I was saying, this is our spot that we were at the very first time. So it's kind of weird being here, but we're only gonna be here for tonight and tomorrow night. And then into the US we go. And the trees are tacos again for the win. Absolutely love these. Not a bad view for dinner either, eh? Milo's quiet now, he already had his dinner. Give him the attention and look, turns back into a little angel. Funny how that works. And we're in bed for the night. Oh, nothing like getting into bed with fresh clean sheets. Such an amazing feeling. Hey, Bubba. See you guys in the morning.
Little bit of a cloudier morning today, but you can still see the moon setting. It's pretty crazy. On camera it looks small, but it's actually quite large. So I think we're gonna sit here and enjoy the coffee, eh? Enjoy the coffee. Wanna say good morning, Bubba?
Yeah.
I don't know if you can see it, but the sun is starting to poke through those clouds. I don't know, looks alright, pretty cool.
It's not bad when you have the coffee, though. Hey, Milo, what do you think? Yeah, you're loving it, too.
So I'm just finishing taking Milo out for his morning walk and pee. Then I think we're going to make some breakfast. And then, like I was saying, Yesterday, the van is a mess, so I'm gonna give her a clean. Probably just throw on a podcast while I do that. It's probably gonna take a little bit of time. It's our last full day in Baja, so it's essentially like clean the van, get everything, you know, organized, and then ready to go for early tomorrow morning. When we leave to go to the border, definitely gonna get up at a good time to get there early, because like from what I've heard and saw when we were coming into Baja, it's like a total, can be a total gong show going back into the US if you get there kind of later in the day. Like you'll be in line for hours, so I'm trying to avoid that. So we're gonna get up early tomorrow.
Just finished cleaning the whole van, wiped everything down. It's crazy how much better it makes you feel in here. It smells so clean, looks so clean. Yaz is probably laughing at me because she's always been like that and I always thought that was so, you know, funny of her. But look at this. Now I feel the exact same way. I don't know what that's about, but definitely feel way better in here. Everything's clean, fresh. Gotta love it. And look how sunny it's gotten. It is so hot now. Not a bad afternoon for the last one in Baja, eh? So I think we're just gonna hang out the rest of the day, enjoy being here, and yeah, just soak it all in. Got the second coffee of the day, and like you probably guessed, this is this hot one. It's an iced latte. Oh, such flex having freezer in this van, like having being able to have ice, unbelievable. You got Milo, his favorite spot on the planet under the van, enjoying the last little bit he has on the beach. Don't think he quite knows it yet though, so I think we're just gonna sit here in this chair and just continue to listen to the podcast and just soak up the sun. Ah, such a nice day out, turned around. Just walking down the beach here, so I wanted to show you what I was talking about. Like, look, now there's like legit waves here. This is what I remember from when we first came. I guess when we first came down, it must have been like a full moon as well, because the moon last night was so big, but it's like no point trying to film it on this camera because it makes it look so small for some reason. But yeah, this is what I remember the tide looking like full-on waves. Might just go for a little dip, pretty hot. Milo's been hanging out in his van right there. Milo's been hanging out under the van literally all day. It's honestly kind of trippy standing here looking at this, you know, setting sky. You got the sun setting back there, but this purple sky right here, it's kind of trippy knowing that this is like gonna be like the last sunset that I'm gonna see in Baja, which is, it's so weird because this is like the first place I saw my first sunset and sunrise in Baja, and it's so insane, man. Like, I know I've said it a million times, it's been a dream here, and there is seriously no amount of money on this planet that I would accept to erase the memories that I've made down here. I'm not even joking, like there's not one, because at the end of the day, that's all you get is the memories. Nothing else really matters after. So just taking this all in, super special place here. Taking Milo for the last night walk on a beach in Baja. Cannot believe that our time here is officially coming to an end. Tomorrow we cross into the US. So sad, honestly. Like, so sad to leave. Like, obviously I'm really excited to, you know, see parts of the US on our way back to Canada, but this place is amazing. I say it all the time, but it truly is a dream being down here. Got the nice sun setting there. Sad. That's all I can say, is that it truly is sad to have our last night here, but I do know we will be back 100%, and we're gonna come back here, so. But yeah, just trying to look forward to what lies ahead in parts of the US I've never seen, so definitely getting excited for that, that's for sure. But we're gonna finish taking this guy out and then get her into a bed mode. got into a bed mode here for our last time in Baja. Just gonna take it easy, probably watch a movie tonight. Get up nice and early, watch our last sunrise here, have a coffee, take this little boy out, have a quick breakfast, and make it to the US border fairly early. I wanna get there nice and early just to avoid any, you know, long waits. You know, it's gonna be probably a process going through the US border and this thing, like going through secondary and everything. So yeah, I just wanted to be as quick as possible and not waste too much time. And yeah, start our journey in the US. So we'll see you guys in the morning.
Good morning. Got the coffee here. Got Milo in my lap. And we're just watching our last sunrise here in Baja. Just soaking it all in before we head to the States. Still crazy to me that we're going to be in the U.S. today, but I think we're just going to enjoy the sunrise, take him out, and then probably hit the road.
Just taking Milo for his morning pee before I get the dishes going, and then we are heading out. So, all right, buddy, this is your last time on the beach. Your last time on the beach. Ah, so sad, like I was saying before, but I am looking forward to it. I just want to pretty much get going at this point and cross the border with hopefully as little drama as possible. So we're gonna get going here. All right, we're all packed up, about to head out. So we'll see you guys in the US. So we made it to Yuma, Arizona. The border crossing was actually not a pain at all. Like, we got there pretty early, so there was still a line, but it went by pretty quick. They were super nice. Like, I was surprised, honestly, how nice they were. I want to correct myself from the last video. I said that the spot I was at was about an hour and a half away. It's more of like 2 and a bit hours away. I got confused because I guess that, from that spot to the border, is like a little bit over 2 hours, and then from the border to Yuma was an hour. That's what I was thinking of. But we're back in Yuma just for the night, because tomorrow, getting some maintenance work done on the van from a mechanic that I've gone to in the past that I like, so figure I'd just come here. Currently in a Cracker Barrel parking lot, so yes, that's the realities of van life sometimes, just in a parking lot here. So thinking after we get that done, he's doing some maintenance work, and then hit Joshua Tree tomorrow. But man, I'm having the biggest issues with my debit card right now because my credit card expired, so I don't have my credit card right now. And my debit card, it happened in Mexico, but I thought it was just a Mexico thing, but I guess it's my card, is that it won't work at machines when, like, you're in a grocery store to pay. For whatever reason, it won't work. But if you go to an ATM, you can pull out money fine. So I went to Walmart, had all my groceries, and it wasn't working, and they didn't have an ATM, so I had to leave my card there, run across the street to a gas station, ATM, pull out money, and go back and pay. So I'm exhausted today. It's been a day, but got it in bed mode here still. We're gonna leave it like that just for the night. Milo's been a trooper today. So yeah, we're just gonna hang out here, take it easy, watch some movies, maybe edit some videos, and yeah, get the van going tomorrow. So see you guys then.
Good morning, even though we are camped out in a Cracker Barrel parking lot. Sometimes that's just the reality of things. We still get great coffee. It's great, even though we're sitting in a parking lot. But the plan today is we're gonna get up, obviously take this guy out, do the few dishes, and then 5 minutes away it's a mechanic we're seeing today just to get a few things done, and then hopefully timing works out well for us and we will make it just to a BLM spot just outside of Joshua Tree National Park. So hopefully that's the plan, and yeah, we'll check back in.
All right, so we got everything packed up, but go to the mechanic. Hopefully it gets done pretty soon. That's what we're going first thing in the morning, and then hopefully we make it to the BLM spot right outside Joshua Tree National Park. So we'll check back in. I know, Bubba. I know, almost. You've been a trooper. Well, this has not gone as planned at all. Like you just saw, been here for 2 weeks waiting for a part for the van, because I guess it is an older model, because parts are A, kind of harder to find and take longer to get here. I'm just lucky that the mechanic, it's a super nice guy, who's let me stay in the van, camp out on his lot until it comes in, because I need a hub assembly for the wheel. So the van right now is like on jack stands because the whole wheel's taken apart. So I'm just super thankful that he's let me stay in the van for the time being, and I don't have to like pay money to be somewhere waiting, which is a plus. Just walking right now to the grocery store. Yeah, it's so hot in this town all the time. It's like a desert. But Milo's just in the van. It's actually a lot cooler in there, obviously, because it's temperature controlled. But yeah, we're just gonna go to the grocery store, pick up a few extra items, and we should be getting out of here very soon. I hope. All right, van's totally done. Got it back in our hands. So this is where I think I'm gonna end it for this video, but follow along next week as Van Life USA begins on the road to Canada.